I think that the history of our firm goes back a long time. We are more than 90 years in existence, and right till the early 90s, we were essentially a boutique shop which specialized in a few areas, including financial services. We were very well reputed, but and were punching way above our weight, but we were small in terms of the size of the operation. The main growth has occurred in the last 15 years. And that's been driven primarily by, I think, three factors. First and foremost, the market grew. The Indian economy really started globalizing and getting more liberal from the early 90s after the policies that the government pursued. So that gave us, firstly, that large amount of transactional work on the basis of which you could build a large corporate firm. So the market opened up. The second important factor was the availability of high quality, employable law graduates from universities that were being set up in using a slightly different model. The national law schools, which were sort of based on a sort of a institution management institutions, they changed the format in terms of legal education. So the availability of high quality law graduates allowed us to recruit and fuel this expansion. And the third factor, which is sort of more personal to us, was a more entrepreneurial, more Western-oriented management culture. Our law firm is structured very similar to many Western organizations. We have formal career tracks, practice groups, and we've tried to use best practice in terms of structuring our organization more institutionally. I think I inspire trust, and a lot of the young generation has believed in the vision that I have spelled out for them. I've been very open in terms of communicating what my vision for the firm, as well as the vision for the Indian legal industry, has been. I'm a firm believer that India's independent law firm sector has got enormous potential, and there are a lot who believe in that vision and who follow me. I see basically two models of law firms in the world. One are the global law firms, or they go by the name of one-stop shops, which will open an office everywhere they see an opportunity and will also practice the local law of that jurisdiction. That's a successful model as well, but that's not the only model. And the other model is those of independent law firms, national champions like ourselves, which have some unique strengths as well. And I think both have their strengths and weaknesses. For practicing cutting-edge work in a jurisdiction, I think the latter model is infinitely superior because you have the best lawyers and the best expertise that is available. We are seeing also the impact of the financial crisis, for instance, on the former model. The former model is driven largely by following financial sector clientele across the world. And when the financial sector itself, the leading global banks and investment banks, they themselves come under pressure, the natural impact on these law firms is also, I mean, they feel the pain with them as well. And like the banks themselves are shrinking, so are the law firms. Whereas firms like ours and in different other jurisdictions, they're somewhat more insulated. There would always be some amount of nervousness, not because we do not substantively recognize those rights, but enforcement can be somewhat slow and patchy. But for a diligent American corporation, which is willing to pursue its intellectual property rights and protect them, India would still deliver the end product. And a number of corporations have experienced that. For instance, companies like some of the leading technology players in the world, I don't want to name them, or even drug manufacturers, they've had, eventually, they've been able to achieve justice.